Hi Poopsies, welcome back to another ASMR video. It's me, Tony Bomboni, ASMR. Now, I did a lot of thinking lately. By the way, this is a new light I just bought thanks to my Poopsie who sent me that Amazon gift card. I bought this light with that money because I feel like it's better. It like brings in the experience closer, and I always needed a camera light mounted on it, which I never had. And a lot of people use these. You know, you can even adjust the dim. Let's see here. Yeah, to something more fitting. You know, it could maybe be like this, or as bright as this, and the camera kind of adjusts to what needs be. I think this is better though, just a little bit darker. There we go. So, I have my channel open here today. We're going to react to my very first ASMR video. Well, actually, my very first one I deleted. I don't know why I did this. I'm just being honest with you. If a video did not do well in viewership, I would delete it after like a while. You know, I'd give it some time to grow and then I'd delete it, which now I realize like I deleted like probably 500,000 views worth of videos. Like, I don't know why I did that. It was just so pointless. But anyway, and those were the videos a lot of people requested back, so I do regret deleting them. Bad Tony, slap on the wrist. But today I've just been having a very different focus for these videos for my channel. It's come time that it's gonna be in a month, 6 years I have this channel, and I hated that it had to come to this, but it's come time to where I have to like, how do I explain? Reinvent myself. Refocus myself, and I'm always honest with you guys and talking to you guys about my struggles, you know, and my real life, my personal life, and what I deal with. And so I just feel like there needed to be change made, and I think my intent for these videos for so long has been about, and a lot of people notice this, and this is just me being real and authentic to the core. And I thought, you know what, bite the bullet, Tony, get it over with, tell them, tell your viewers, because you care about them, you know, be honest with them. There were a lot of ASM artists who noticed this, who I've had struggles with, and that's the genuineness, authenticness to the channel, to the videos, to me, how I come across with people. And I don't want to start crying now, but I just feel like for so long I've been focusing so hard on, you know, how much I'll earn from this channel in return, in retrospect, whereas I should have been focusing my energy on how many people I could have helped and the impact I could make on this channel. And so, I don't even know if this is the right place to address this. Maybe I'll make this in a separate video. But I just feel like I've been focusing for so long on that. And then I got most of what I wanted out of it. But then the natural universal karmic law kind of bites you back in the butt after a while when you don't start something with the right intention. For so long, I've been wanting to help people. I want to do humanitarian work. That's what I really want to do. Ignoring the pay, ignoring how much hard work it is, ignoring having to be strong and witness many people's struggles. But that's something I want to do. That's one of my dreams, is to do that kind of work. And I don't know if I'm really hitting the mark or getting my full potential on this channel by doing ASMR. I'm sure it's helped many of you. I know it has. I know all those long emails I've read from my viewers saying they're in the hospital, saying they're pregnant, saying they're going through a divorce, a breakup. So many. I wish I could remember them all, but my mind would just be so overwhelmed because of how many people have been there for me and that I've been there for them. And so you might notice a shift, you know. I don't know if one day I'll just like magically drop these videos and stop filming, or if I'll just keep continuing. But you're gonna notice a change. You're gonna notice videos that I want to do because I want to and I care to. A lot of you have been recommending that I get a job to focus away from this, not because of the money, because the money is taken care of for now, unless that drops too, you know, you can't predict, and things aren't the same on YouTube as they used to be, so I wouldn't be surprised if that happened, where I had to be forced to get a job. But more to get a job, just to get out of the house more, interact with people more, and regardless of the pay, you know. And I think, I don't know if it's gonna happen yet, there might be an opportunity for me to do that. So during that time, I might be posting less often, but I think it'll be better for me. And it gives me experience working with people, because I've worked self-employed for so long. As far as I can remember, I've worked like heavy jobs, like home remodeling with my father, and I don't know, there was just something so satisfying about doing hands-on work and working all day, and then at the end of the day you come home and you just feel tired but satisfied. And after a while, that's not the satisfaction I get from doing videos, you know, because it's so routine, so easy, and so hard at the same time. I can't say it's that easy. There is a struggle for everything, but I just feel like there's more to my purpose, and there's more I can do with my destiny, fulfill my purpose, than YouTube videos. And I feel like YouTube is, in a sense, holding me back from those things, you know. Again, not talking on a financial standpoint, you know, I've been doing okay the last few years, more than okay. But I feel like it would be worth it to give that up, to take the leap for something better long term. You know, it might not give me the results I seek short term, but long term it might reward me. But as long as I don't focus on the reward, I just focus on how I can make an impact and how many people I can truly help. This is by now probably going to go in another video of its own. I'm sorry if you're seeing this video and I'm next to a laptop and you're confused why. Watch the next video and you'll see why. But to get me by some days, like literally there are days I won't even feel like filming videos, and I will just think about which person I could help next, and that pushes me to keep going. The dollar amount does no longer push me as it used to. It's no longer a genuine thing I'm seeking for, you know. For so long I was wondering, honestly, how much like I could make monthly, and I've always had such a strong business head. But I notice in the ASMR community that does not, I think in YouTube in general, that just does not apply. The law of that does not apply. Like, you will fail if you focus on that, if your heart is not genuinely there. And my heart is still in these videos, which is why, I keep doing them. I love them. I can't stop. You know the saying, someone who just quits their job or leaves does not truly love it. I know that deep down here, because I cannot quit on you guys no matter what happens, no matter what changes YouTube makes, you know, they're just killing off channels left and right, and some of my favorite channels are just drifting away because people are just leaving them and just abandoning them. It's just so sad, and there was a lot of changes made lately, and on a spiritual standpoint, I think it's time in my life to move on to something that will fulfill me more. You know, I'm gonna keep trying and pushing, as I always do, for my betterment, because I still have, obviously, bills to pay. You know, no one's gonna pay my bills. I just bought a house, but now it's like everything is at once because I just made a major life decision, and now it's all of a sudden taking a rapid turn because I'm becoming more awake and cutting to the chase, cutting the bull, you know, just getting to the real core with you guys. And that's what I've been doing on my vlog channel as well. I'm totally real on there, totally sharing my problems, sharing my good moments, my authentic me. And that's why I love doing the vlogs as well, because I feel like it takes time away from having to pretend everything's okay for a while, you know. And it just makes me sad to see when people are not like enjoying doing their videos anymore, and I don't want to become that, you know. And I've been taking little breaks in between here and there, you know, and I might just end up doing like few videos and then you'll not see me for like a week, you know, or two. So but I'll definitely let you know, I've always been real with you, regardless of what people think, regardless of criticism. We are all entitled to an opinion. That's okay if you think differently of me, you know, but this is the message I want to bring about to people, because no amount of money can make anyone happy. That was the hard lesson I've had to learn. No amount of things you buy, no amount of affection with people, you know, getting into relationships, unless you're not the one that can work on yourself and make yourself happy. And that's ultimately my goal, is to be a humanitarian and through that find my happiness. And I just like spit out my dream to you guys. Like, I never told a soul this besides my family, but you know what? I thought I'd spit it out there. Maybe someone knows something of how I can get started, or, you know, maybe I can just figure it out myself with time. But it's just that one thing that I'm scared to do, is like get up and go and just leave home and just go for my dream. And it makes me like feel sick to even abandon the channel, you know? But at this point, it almost feels right. I don't know how I'm gonna figure things out. I don't know how I'm gonna figure myself out, but I think it's just come to a point where it's like, imagine you're climbing a mountain and you're coming to the peak and you're trying to climb higher, but the peak has already peaked. So you're literally like stacking rocks on top of each other and like trying to climb the rock, and then you're like tripping and falling, and you just keep falling, and it's just like, it's like God's message, just like move on, you know. So again, not saying I'm gonna quit the channel, not saying I'm leaving, that's not what I'm intending to do at all. But if I suddenly just vanish one day, you'll probably know why. It won't come with much warning, just like a volcano. And I wanted to do a video about that Guatemala volcano, which I will do soon. You'll see that on here. But I just want to be genuine. I want to be real with you. I no longer want to worry. Like, honestly, even these sponsors are so exhausting. It's so disingenuous. I just feel like I don't want to be the bad guy. I don't want to be the evil person. And the karma of that came back because I felt like I just kept pushing people away, you know, to focus on the channel. I just kept minding my own business, doing my own thing for so long, and you know, I finally got the chance to work with genuine people, and it just, I just ruined it because they're right. Yes, I did start to bring in some cash flow for myself, you know. I don't think there's something wrong with that, but when you start it, just thinking about that, it doesn't end well. It just never ends well. And I've been mixing in wanting to help people along the way, which is why it lasts so long. But like, to the down, to the core, like I want to give my all to just helping people. That's why I feel like I'm here. Otherwise, I feel like I'm wasting my time here on earth. Like, I don't want to live to work. I want to live to enjoy the work and know that it's going somewhere and doing a purpose. And I know a lot of you could say, well, Tony, you are helping people in the process, but to succeed, you need to help little people, a little bit of people with big problems, or a lot of people with little problems. And if I can just help a few people with big problems, I've done my job. If I can help a lot of people, each with little bit of problems, I've done my job. So that's to the core what I want to do. Money is no longer the motive. Money is no longer the focus. It does nothing for me. It just added stress in my life. I remember I was happier when I made a lot less. I wonder why. Because I had something to work towards, to add people to work towards, to people that genuine caring relationships in my life. And I ruined those time and time again because I was too busy. I couldn't make the appointment. I couldn't meet you up for coffee because I was too busy. You know, and I care about my family a lot, you know. I wanted them and their security to be safe, and I know I'm rambling, but this is going to be its own video by now. So make sure to check out the other video where I react to my very first ASMR video. Okay.